this may be the future of COVID vaccines. Current COVID-19 vaccines are made differently, yet they have one thing in common: encourage the body to produce neutralizing antibodies. However, such vaccines are vulnerable to variants. So some vaccine studies are focusing on immune cells. But before we continue, please like this video if you find this informative and subscribe to our channel for more interesting and informative content. Don't forget to click the bell icon too to get the latest updates. According to Medical News Today, researchers warn that as the virus continues to mutate, variants may resist these antibodies and thus escape the protection of currently available vaccines. So people will need boosters whenever a new, heavily mutated variant comes out. What if vaccines don't have to target viral parts that mutate? That's exactly what scientists at the Broad Stem Cell Research Center and the University of California are trying to do. They are working on newer vaccines that attack less likely parts of the virus to mutate. To be fair, this approach wasn't likely practical when COVID-19 exploded across the globe. Current vaccines were the best bet to catch up with the pandemic, and so far, they did a good job keeping humanity in the game. Yet they're not enough to end this pandemic and stop variants from spiking cases. In the journal Cell Reports, the team focused their attention on T-cells, white blood cells that fight infections. During patrols, they use a unique protein called the T-cell receptor to detect fragments of foreign proteins called antigens. Upon detection, the receptors would lead T-cells to the source of antigens. During this process, the cells would replicate so quickly to destroy infected cells and pathogens. To learn if T-cells are viable in vaccines, they tested if the receptors would react to a part of SARS-CoV-2 called RDRP. Samples from healthy individuals were collected and exposed to RDRP. Some receptors recognized the protein, a promising start. Then, they analyzed the receptors for genetic sequencing. Results allowed them to engineer T-cells to carry those receptors to track RDRP better. The method was a success where the cells killed the coronavirus. What made the findings better was the highly conserved RDRP, which is unlikely to mutate in human coronaviruses. The research is still in its infancy, but scientists see that antibodies aren't the only ones vaccines can mobilize to stop SARS-CoV-2. Hopefully, this approach can lead us to better vaccines. Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.